God is the same way, I think. Holy, holy, holy. Lord God of hosts. This is a holy God. And when we stand before the presence of God, there's a certain part where I do want to fall on my knees. But because you are a child of God, he says, come into the inner sanctum. Come into this room and make your petition before me, and you are welcome to do it. And so the flip side of this is, even though there was this awe and respect, I knew I was a MacDonald. I was one of the Mac boys, and I was allowed to be in there, and I had every right to stand as a family member in that room. Do you have that confidence with God the Father, through Jesus the Son, through the power of the Holy Spirit? Oh my goodness, what a gift. So today, if anything you leave, I want you to leave knowing that you've been encouraged. Now, I have to conclude the sermon with a curveball. There's always a curveball. Jesus never just hits it straight. There's a curveball coming at you. Take a look at Luke 11. What does Jesus end the text with? It's buried there in verse 13. I won't keep going. I won't stop until I hear somebody tell me. What are you supposed to pray for?
Holy Spirit.
You pray for the Holy Spirit. I didn't know I was called to pray for the Holy Spirit. I thought I was supposed to pray for my sick grandma. Yes, you're supposed to pray for your sick grandma. But interestingly, Jesus is leading the witness. He says that. How much more is your Father in heaven going to give you everything you want? So when you ask the Holy Spirit, I didn't even know I'm supposed to ask the Holy Spirit. I'll tell you the problem with the church. We got a lot of people busy doing all sorts of stuff, a lot of people praying for all sorts of stuff, and we're not in the Holy Spirit. You need to call upon God's Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, come and anoint me. Because when that happens, all of a sudden it changes. There's so much to say on this. Oh my goodness, there's so much to say. There's other sermons. There's another day. Praise God. This too will end. But I'll tell you, the Holy Spirit comes. And it shakes us and it molds us. And then what happens is you stop praying your shopping list. You start just enjoying the presence of God. Your whole life becomes a prayer. Do you know it's buried in Scripture? It says, pray without ceasing. What, are you an idiot? You walk around just praying all the time? No. It's because when you're anointed in the Holy Spirit, your life becomes a prayer. Everything you do is prayerful. It is not I in them, but Christ who lives in me. You die to the self. The only way you can die to the self is for the Holy Spirit to come in you. Do you hunger for that intimacy with God? That's where we need to reside. And when we do, and when he gets a hold of us, he'll start transforming you, and me to such a degree, this church will be so full, you won't know what to do. But until we come and anointed of the Holy Spirit, we'll just keep bumping along. So I truly leave you with this last story. It is the story of C.S. Lewis. It's in the film Shadowland. If you want to watch a good film this summer, Shadowland. It's the story of C.S. Lewis and his love affair and marriage to Joy Gresham. The scene that I want to bring to your mind is that Lewis is coming home from London to Oxford, because he's a professor, as you know, at Oxford University. And he had just married in London Joy, but she's in a hospital bed. She's dying of cancer. And they get married. So he comes back to London, back to Oxford, and he meets his priest, his minister friend. And the minister friend knows that Joy is struggling with cancer, but the minister doesn't know that he just got married, that he just married her. And the minister says to Lewis, "How goes it, Jack?" Jack, C.S. Lewis was named Jack. "How goes it, Jack?" Jack decides to talk about the wedding and not the cancer and says, "It goes well, Harry. It goes very well. It was a wonderful day." And then the minister turns and says, thinking that Lewis was talking about the cancer, because he doesn't know about the wedding, he says, "It's about time, because God answer your prayers. And this is what Lewis says. It's too good for me to paraphrase. I'm going to quote because I wrote it out. This is what Lewis responds. That's not why I pray, Harry. I pray because I can't help myself. I pray because I'm helpless. I pray because the need flows out of me all the time, waking and sleeping. It doesn't change God, Harry. It changes me. It doesn't change God. It changes me. Prayer is not a message scribbled on a note, jammed into a bottle, and tossed into the sea in hopes that it will one day wash up on God's shoreline. Prayer is communion with God. We speak to God, and God touches, embraces, shapes, and changes us. Whether we pray for rain, or whether we pray for sunshine, our prayer is answered because in the act of praying, we receive the gift that we really seek. Intimacy with God. I'm going to ask Linda to come forward for prayer, but I'm just going to start with the Lord's Prayer. And I ask you to bow your heads and say the traditional prayer. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever. I ask that you make yourself comfortable for our intercessions.